Okay, today I'm going to be trying to trick a harvester ant into thinking it's dead. I call this the Night of the Living Dead experiment. Okay, so if you've ever watched a colony of ants, you may have noticed that when an ant dies, if it's not crushed by anything, if it just dies of natural causes and its body's just left there, the other ants don't really care about it. They kind of just walk around it and don't really do anything with the body. That is until about 2 days afterwards. Then the ants pick up the dead ant and they take it to a place in their colony that's called the graveyard. So the graveyard is a place in every colony where all of the live ants take the dead ants. So in 1950, a young assistant professor named Ed Wilson at Harvard noticed this fact. He noticed that the ants don't really care about a dead ant until around 2 days later. And so he started to wonder about that. He said, why don't they take it to the graveyard right away if it's dead? Why do they wait till 2 days afterward? And that made him begin to think that maybe it's because the ant begins to decay and it lets off some chemical that lets the other ants know that it's dead. So Ed went on to revolutionize the study of ants. He found that ants communicate through mostly smell. And in his research, he set out to discover what smell it is, what chemical is it that ants actually let out when they die. So with trial and error, working with different dead animals, trying to extract different chemicals from rotting bodies, he discovered the one specific chemical that triggers ants to know that they're dead. And that chemical is called oleic acid. And so how he tested this is he grabbed a little dab of oleic acid, he put it on the back of an ant that was passing by in one of his colonies, and he noticed that almost immediately, some of the other ants grabbed that ant and took it over to the ant graveyard. And the ant that had the oleic acid on it was pretty willing. It just accepted its fate. It thought, I'm dead, take me to the graveyard. And it stayed in the graveyard until eventually it cleaned itself off and joined the colony again. So in order to test that today, I have myself some oleic acid and a nice colony of harvester ants. So I got these ants a few days ago. I was actually really excited because for some reason my whole life I've always wanted an ant farm, but I never got one. So I finally got an ant farm and it's pretty cool. I got a kind that's filled with gel so you can actually see the tunnels. And as soon as you put them in, they just go right to work and they start digging. And what's really cool, just like in that story I told, as soon as some of the ants started dying naturally, the other ants started making a graveyard for the ants. So as of today, there's about 10 ants that have died. You can see their body in the refuse pile here. So the question is, what happens when I put oleic acid on one of them? Is it gonna think it's dead itself? Will the other ants think it's dead? What will happen? And I should mention this chemical that I'm putting on it does not hurt the ants at all. It has acid in the name, but it's actually just a vegetable oil or an animal fat. So it definitely won't hurt the ant. Okay, first let's try to capture one of the harvester ants.
Okay. That was easy. It's so easy because they get so mad when something enters their cage, they just start biting it. So he's just biting the straw right now.
Okay, so now let's put some oleic acid on him and see if we can trick everyone into thinking that he's dead. Okay, so in order to be able to work with him a little bit better, I'm gonna put it in the freezer. So this doesn't hurt him at all. In fact, when you get the ants from the store, they come in a tube and they suggest you put the tube in the fridge for a little bit in order to transfer them to their new environment. So it definitely doesn't hurt the ants, but it slows its metabolism down. So then I can apply the oleic acid.
Okay, there you go, Mr. Ant. Enjoy your time amongst the ice cream and fresh frozen raspberries.
Okay, we've got our ant in there. He's not dead, he's just cold. Okay, now let's put some oleic acid on him.
Just gonna do a little dab.
Okay, let's put him back in. Oh, he's starting to wake up. Let's put him back in and see if they think he's dead. So I was gonna try to mark the one that I was going to put the oleic acid on, but what's easier than that is I'm just gonna track it digitally. So I'll mark it with kind of a dot or an arrow as we go, and that's the one that has the oleic acid on it. Okay, he's in the back there, right there. Let's see how they treat him.
Looks like he may be volunteering to go into the graveyard. He thinks he's dead. It's interesting. It looks like he thinks that he needs to be over in the graveyard area. His chemical senses are telling him to bring the dead thing over to the graveyard, but it's on him. So there he is again. He really just wants to hang out in this graveyard area. You can see the bulk of the other ones stay over in this area. They usually congregate around here, but they don't really hang out in this area unless they're bringing a dead ant over. But he's just hanging out on the pile as if he were dead. So that's really interesting. In the study, it was the other ants who brought it over, but in this case, it looks like he's hanging out in the area of the dead ants. Maybe the impulse is just to go to that area because it senses the oleic acid. Those are three other dead ants right there, and this is the one who thinks it's dead. So you can see that he'll eventually clean himself off, get all the oleic acid off, and then just return back to his normal society. Okay, so after a while, they've all resumed their normal activities. It's been about an hour since I put the oleic acid on, and they all seem fine. They're just crawling around, still building their tunnels now. And don't forget, I'm taking pre-orders for my very first subscription box. So if you like the videos and you like the experiments that you see me do on my channel and you really want to try them, join the Action Lab subscription box. And every quarter, I'll send you a box filled with awesome experiments. This is a really cool, really well put together box. I teamed up with the makers of the Curiosity Box from Vsauce's channel, and they do an awesome job at creating subscription boxes. So head over to theactionlab.com to pre-order your first subscription box. The first one is going to be in pretty limited quantity, so get it while you can. And if you're not subscribed to my channel yet, hit the subscribe button and hit the bell to be notified when my latest video's out. And thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.